everyone, and welcome to our weekly Q&A live stream. I'm your host, Mod Light. Joining me today are the wonderful mods Arcane, Kieran, Elena, and Husky. How are you guys doing today? Arcane, I'll start with you first.
I'm pretty good. I saw a house today, and it was really good. So I put my name down. Can't wait to be declined. That'd be great.
Fantastic. Level up that construction. How about you, Elena? What's up?
Yeah, I'm doing well, thank you. I've got a bit of a cough, so I'm not going to be talking too much today, but hopefully I'll be okay through the next hour or so. I was helping out with the Deadman Mode beta today, and that was really fun.
Awesome, we really, really appreciate you being here. Husky, how are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm good. Don't know what else to say, just fine.
Surviving. And Kieran, welcome. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm in the office right now, so I'm in a bit of a weird environment. Hopefully my mic sounds still pretty good. I'm in a little meeting room in the office, a really small one.
Looks fab. A great game jam stream yesterday, by the way. It was really, really entertaining and really fun. I hope chat really enjoyed it. Today we've got a stream with some TOA questions to begin with. Thanks to the wonderful Arcane for joining us. And then we're going to get into your group Iron Man changes questions. So let's start with some announcements. Exclamation mark game update. We've updated some items in our equipment rebalancing stuff. There's long-awaited Pole 76 changes, so go check that out with exclamation mark game update. Exclamation mark Giants Foundry. The poll is actually live. And we've updated the blog to version 3, which seems to be received really, really well. Check out the blog for all the changes. Feedback so far has been really good. Exclamation mark GIM changes, which is what we're talking about today. We're introducing potentially an unranked GIM mode along with a raffle. And it's what we're going to be discussing on our Q&A today. And finally, exclamation mark TOA rewards. We actually just published a blog about updating the TOA rewards. Arcane is going to be talking about that today. So exclamation mark TOA rewards if you haven't seen the blog yet. So first things first, the amazing mod Arcane is here just to chat with us about some of the new rewards from the blog. So Arcane, do you want to talk about some of the new changes that went live today in the blog?
Yeah, so we had, we've already had like a big poll and a big blog with all the TOA rewards, all of them passed. But there's a couple of them that we felt like could be improved slightly, whether it was like we just didn't really like what this reward's become, or mathematically some weapons weren't really achieving what we liked in the best way. And then some players just had some really good ideas for alternative rewards. So we kind of wanted to just offer like some changes. So we released a blog today, and it's got three big things on it. So I'll go from smallest to biggest, and so most of the questions that I've curated are about the big ticket item. The first one is changing how the Osmundson's Fang calculates accuracy. So instead of it rolling for accuracy once, if it rolls and then fails, it'll roll again. So you get this really interesting damage curve that we have on the blog that basically makes it an incredibly accurate weapon. We rebalanced some of the stats slightly, so we brought it down from 175 accuracy to like 105, because with this double accuracy roll, it's really, really accurate. So we just had to rebalance the stats a bit, but we feel like it feels what it was trying to do a lot better now without feeling as artificial, since 175 accuracy on a one-handed weapon felt a little weird. So that's one potential change that if everyone likes, we'll go ahead with. It's effectively still the same weapon, it's just doing it slightly differently. The second reward was a new reward offered that players suggested, which was a upgrade to the rune pouch. So the rune pouch can hold three types of runes right now, 16k each. Basically, this reward would let you upgrade your pouch into a four-slot rune pouch, so you can have four 16k different types of runes inside of it. Four-slot rune pouch, obviously really, really powerful. There's so much utility you get from magic all over the game. I imagine this is going to be a really, really desirable item. The one caveat is we're thinking about making this item untradeable. So the idea is you would have to do TOA to get this reward. That being said, we wouldn't have it as like a crazy rare item, like hundreds of hours or anything like that. We'd expect it to be like fairly common. So maybe you go there and do like 20, 50 KC and you'd expect to get this item. Obviously TOA scales in difficulty a lot as well. So it's not just going to only be this crazy difficult raid. You can kind of customize the difficulty to your nature. So we're hoping it like is quite approachable for most players to go do TOA for a bit, get this reward for whoever you really are. You don't have to be an expert PVMer to get that. But yeah, let us know what your feedback is on this. We think it's a really good idea to have untradeable rewards from most content, so then every piece of content has purpose for everyone. Because currently, right now, Iron Man have to do everything, but regular accounts, you can just skip 90% of the game and just go sit at TOB until the end of the day and make a lot of money, which isn't really great gameplay. So yeah, let us know what you think. The last one, which is going to be the bulk of this quickfire question session, is the new mage weapon. So the Hecker, which was the previously offered mage weapon, was this like fast attacking, alternate variable speed weapon with some unique spellbook effects. People really liked the idea of this like wacky weapon with unique spellbook interactions and the alternating gameplay, but it just didn't really feel like enough. And we buffed the numbers and we changed like a bunch of things around, and it objectively was like a strong upgrade, but it still just didn't feel like that Tebow. It didn't feel like that Scythe. TOA was missing that one item that purely drives a demand of wanting to do that content for years and years to come, like Tebow and Scythe always will have. So we wanted to basically revisit that. And we don't think it's right to keep iterating on Hecker again and again and again. It gets really confusing and like it muddies the water a lot. So we're proposing a new mage weapon that would basically replace the Hecker. This isn't to say the Hecker would never happen ever again. We can use it in the future. But for TOA, the idea is we would offer this new mage weapon instead of the Hecker if it passes. So this new mage weapon is called the Shadow of Tumakan. The Shadow of Tumakan is going to be a two-handed 5-tick staff. It's going to have moderate stats, 35 accuracy, 20 defense, nothing special, a bit of prayer. But it has one really, really important effect. While it's equipped, all of your magic strength from gear is tripled. All of your magic accuracy from gear is tripled. So this makes all of your individual gear switches incredibly valuable. So this is going to make Seer's Ring a lot of accuracy. Everything gets more and more powerful. It heavily incentivizes you to bring more and more switches, which kind of differentiates it. We don't have any two-handed 5-tech mage weapons, which should be a bit more interesting to use and obviously fits that whole Scythe and Tebow, like the big weapon need. So we're hoping that it's going to be like quite interesting in that regard, but that bonus accuracy that you get is actually huge. Like, this is going to make it the most accurate weapon in the game by quite a margin, and it's going to make it actually possible to mage some bosses like Zilliana and Kriara. Any boss that has pretty high regular defense and pretty high magic defense, this weapon's accuracy will actually make it viable to use mage at those bosses like Zilliana and Kriara. If you want more information about like what bosses this might actually be good at, check the blog. There's a bunch of examples in there. But that's generally the idea. I think this is a pretty crazy weapon. I'm just going to go over a couple of the common questions we've had since releasing it. Will the accuracy and damage triple passive only work with the inbuilt spell or with all spells casted while wielding the staff? It'll only be work with the inbuilt spell because it's more like a powered staff similar to Sang and everything. It'll be anything you attack with that inbuilt spell. So if you manually cast a barrage, you're not going to be benefiting from the triple accuracy and damage. That'd be crazy. I liked the Hecker. Can we still have it? There was a lot of the sentiment that the Hecker was quite quirky and unique. I think going forward, we generally feel raids aren't the place to have these like wacky weird rewards. I think we kind of want to really push like these really powerful demand best in slot items from raids. For other pieces of content like group bosses and solo bosses, I think that'd be the area to experiment with more interesting items like the Hecker. So we definitely are still interested in offering that weapon, just proposing that potentially not from here. We can't equip the ward at the same time. Is this a problem? So there's a bit of sentiment around. We have the offhand, the Ward of Eladinus, which is a new best in slot mage offhand from TOA as well as passed. You wouldn't be able to equip that with the Shadow. So obviously it's kind of lame. Like, you kind of want to equip your two new best in slot items from this raid. I get the sentiment behind that completely. The ward is still going to have a lot of use, right? Wherever you're using Barrage and like Kodai and things like that, it's still going to be best in slot. Wherever you're still going to use Sang, because 4-tick is still really relevant, and all of that health that Sang can give you is still going to be very desirable in a lot of pieces of content, the ward is still going to be really relevant for that as well. So it's not like the ward has no purpose, but it's obviously got less purpose compared to the Hecker. But I don't think that's necessarily a problem. But obviously, let us know what you think. Magic is still kind of broken. Why not fix magic as a whole? So this is something we've talked about quite a lot. Magic as a whole is kind of wonky. Like, things have got like ridiculously high defenses. The standard spellbook's quite lackluster and janky. There's a lot of things we can improve about Magic. We still want to do that. It's just a huge project and we want to do it right. That's not something we're looking to tackle with TOA as a whole. It's going to be a bit smaller scale, but we'd definitely be interested in doing that in the future for sure. The weapon doesn't have any drawbacks like Scythe or T-Bow. Is it too strong? So Scythe can only be used realistically on a 3x3. T-Bow can only be used effectively on a monster that's got like 200 plus magic level. So that's kind of seen as a restriction. In reality, it's not really much of a restriction. Most bosses in the game are 3x3 or above, and Scythe's pretty good at. T-Bow's got a lot of monsters, so it's not really niche. It's kind of like a fake niche. But I get the point, right? It gives you a different way to balance a weapon and give other weapons viability. What we're kind of leaning on here is the fact that you need quite a lot of magic switches for this weapon to get really, really powerful and really, really worth using. So that's kind of the drawback. If you only want to bring the Sang or a one-way switch, this weapon isn't very good. And obviously you're going to lose all the healing from Sang if you're comparing it to that. If we do eventually get around to rebalancing the whole elemental and harm, etc., harm would still have its purpose, its power. So we don't think it's necessary, but again, give us feedback if you feel like it's too strong. It's obviously an iterative process. I wrote down a lot of questions about the harm in general, like, can we buff the harm? Can we like fix the auto cast with the harm? We agree with all of this, right? Tome of Fire is kind of janky. The auto cast system is kind of janky. Harm's just in a really weird space where it's just really, really rare. But we're still aware of it. We're not looking to fix it short term or anything. I think the best solution personally is just reworking elemental spells and elemental defenses and stuff like that. So it's more natural where harm ends up becoming better at. This may end up affecting harm and Tome of Fire in some different ways as well. But I think that would fall into that whole magic rework as a whole. Yeah, I think I managed to finish with 2 minutes spare. Nice. Did anyone see anything else in the questions? Check Twitch chat.
That was fantastic, Arcane. I really appreciate you going over all of those questions, especially as they were only gathered within, I would say, like half an hour, because the blog just went live. And I'm sure that we will address more of the feedback in the blog if we need to, as well as check out everyone's feedback over the next few days. So yeah, really appreciate your time, Arcane. Thank you so much. And I'm really loving the chat's reaction so far to all of the changes.
Awesome.
Absolute speed.
Right. I guess we will say goodbye to Arcane and get into some of the GIM questions, if that's okay.
You can kick me off. Say bye. Message me on Discord if you got more questions. See ya.
Yeah, cool. Okay, awesome. All right, so now we're going into the GIM section of the Q&A, which is what you guys are waiting for, I'm sure. The blog we published on Thursday talked about some changes that we want to bring in for Group Iron Man. So it's !! Group Iron Man changes or GIM changes. If you haven't seen the blog yet, definitely catch up on that. I'll summarize the blog in short. So the first thing that we pitched is an unranked Group Iron Man mode. It's basically a way for Group Iron Man to merge groups. Currently, if you want to invite a new Group Iron Man to your existing group, the new member needs to be a fresh account, and unranked Group Iron Man would allow existing Group Iron Man players to merge. We're also talking about a Group Iron Man boss bash. So this is a raffle competition, basically encouraging Group Iron Man to participate in group activities. You earn raffle points. System holds no in-game value at all. They're not tradable. It just enters you into a raffle where you win either 1 year's or lifetime membership if you're lucky enough. And then we also touched upon the idea of tradable untradables, which was pitched, I think, in December. We held off on that change, and obviously the community had a lot to say about that. So we're hoping to get into your questions for the team today. We're going to start off with questions about the group boss bash, and then we'll go into stuff like untradables and things like that. So first question I'm starting with is, lots of MMOs and other popular games use events to boost engagement. One great thing about old school is how conservatively this is applied. What can you do to reassure players that OSRS won't lean too far into events and other limited releases? I did put a few notes on this, so I'll start first. Just as I said earlier, there are no in-game items to be won. And this kind of raffle idea is something that we have talked about in the past on live streams, and it was received quite positively as a concept. We felt that given the fact that we would like to bring in some changes to Group Iron Men in the form of increasing accessibility, we thought this is like the perfect opportunity to tempt people who are maybe no longer playing just to come back, or existing players who might want to have a new goal to work towards. We think it's just something fun, and we're just kind of trialing it to see how it goes. And we definitely care about the community response. That's kind of why we have a survey for feedback, and we're seeing how you guys respond to it, really. So that's kind of my piece. What do you guys think as developers?
So I think the first point about sort of how conservative old school is with events is absolutely so important. That's the thing that I think is at the top most list. It's kind of one of these things, these home old school. As much as we've not really written it down as a golden rule, it's one of these things that is absolutely paramount to, that when we're thinking about stuff like this. So the way I kind of think of it is, no matter when you play, whether you want to play tomorrow, next week, at the weekend, it doesn't give you any inherent advantages to your progression on your account, be it the skill leveling, access to like different rewards, whatever it is. So that would rule out something like a double XP weekend or something like that, which would obviously increase engagement, but in what school sees as not a way that fits our philosophy. While something like a competition, we're seeing a little bit differently. Yes, to increase engagement, it's a bit of fun, that's on one hand, but a competition is just that, it's kind of separate. The rewards are external to your account, and thus you don't care about membership, and that's not really what you're going for. It's only a nice little extra if you win anyway. It's just a little bit of a nudge, a little bit of fun to have, as opposed to I need to do this because I'm going to get double experience or something like that. If that all makes sense. That's kind of what I wanted to say on this sort of, in that sort of topic.
Well, does any other devs want to jump in, or?
I guess it's like a good timing for this. Oh, sorry, you go, Husky.
Lagging or not, but yeah, I saw a lot of people bring up the whole, like, why is it just Iron Man only? And I think it just ties down to what Ben said there is, you know, we're trying some restriction to get people back into playing with their friend, give these, to maybe come back and do a fun event. A lot of them's underlying have been to see how can we make this more of a structure so that if we want apply this to other game modes, like Iron Man, mains, the rest of the community, maybe it's not bosses, it's other things, very easy to sort of expand on. So we're definitely writing it in that sort of way where it's not going to be a lot of work for another developer to do that. And that just comes down to whether or not players want to have these kind of things where, you know, they're competing like for membership, really. They're not competing for, you know, like a limited like item, you know, or boost in their XP or something.
I agree with that.
What I was going to say was, I think it's just like a good time to have that competition for Group Iron Man now, specifically because we're going to be focusing on group bosses. And if you were there at the beginning of Group Iron Man when it launched, you're probably at a place now where you're looking to get into bossing. Obviously, some people have been bossing for a while already. Some are really fast, but I think like people who don't play as much are getting to that point now, and this could be a really good push to like really like go try something new. Perhaps, you know, my gear might not be optimal, but I can still have fun going DKs with my group, and maybe we'll win some membership at the same time.
Sounds really exciting to me. All right, so moving on to the next question, how will the raffle tickets affect your chance of winning? Because it works as a raffle, right? It's not like the most amount of people, or the most amount of points wins. So can you explain a bit more about that side of things?
Yeah, Yeah, I think the term raffle is just the best sort of way to describe it. I'm not sure if people, like maybe people aren't familiar with that, but if you can imagine every time you kill a boss, that's a ticket to the hat with your name on it, right? You know, and if you've got more tickets in this hat, when we pull out the winners, there's your group's name is going to be on this ticket, right? And then the first name we pull out, I think, was it, have we announced how much membership they're getting yet? Have we done that?
We have, yeah. Know, but...
Cool. So yeah, like first ticket would be lifetime, then the next like nine would be like, I think it's a year or something like that, right? So obviously you could be, you know, all maxed accounts, super efficient, playing 12 hours a day, and you might still only have like 5% of the tickets, right? You know, it'd be 1 in 20 chance. And there's only 10 pools, you know, we all like our drop rates in RuneScape. Maybe it's still not the best, but you're increasing your odds, right? So I think this makes it like more fair and open to a lot of people. It's less about like, can I game and how can I optimize and get the most kills per hour, but more just, hey, let's participate in this. Maybe change up our activities. Maybe we were all considering going and doing, I don't know, a bunch of Slayer bosses. You know, they're not included in the list. We're going to grind up Primordials. And now maybe instead you're going to say, hey, let's do some Nightmare tonight. Let's see if we get lucky, get an Inquisitor's piece, get an orb, or and also get some raffle tickets on the side, you know?
Awesome, great. So next question is, the raffle system sounds like a great idea. Are we planning or looking at implementing the raffle system for other types of accounts? I can actually speak to that. I looked at the survey results today. I know it's only been 24 hours, but it does seem like the majority of respondents to that survey seemed in favor of implementing the system across, you know, not just Group Iron Man, but other types of accounts. So I was wondering, what do you guys think about this? Kieran, we'll start with you first.
Absolutely. It's got potential to do that. And so this is kind of, as you say, it's just an experiment almost to begin with, and playing with Group Iron Man. We like the social dynamics of groups, getting Group Iron Man to almost do something together is part of the desire here. But now that we've got a system, it can naturally be extended in theory to all accounts or indeed different types of content. It doesn't have to be bosses. It could be anything arbitrary. As long as we tell you what it is and give you a list of points per completion or whatever, we could absolutely do that. And I think it even ties into one of the ideas we talked about in the Game Jam yesterday. We like this sort of seasonal high score system. Like in theory, we can sort of provide a competition like most agility laps completed, you know, that maybe isn't the most exciting idea. But you can imagine the same system, right? Every lap you complete, you get a ticket. And we could even have that on the high scores so you can see actually how many tickets you've got compared to other people. Like, I think there's a lot of potential to do more of this. But we are going to be looking at sort of how well does this one work? Does the community like it? And sort of base our decision on that. But it does certainly seem like there's appetite for this to extend to other things too.
Awesome. Great. So tell us if you like it, guys, and tell us if you don't. We want to know. But hopefully you like it. Next question. Will there be free-to-play bosses added to the boss bash? Do we know?
Full list is in the blog, right?
Free to play. Yeah, I believe. So we've been focusing on group bosses, and there aren't really any group bosses in free to play, I think. So yeah, it's only pay to play for now.
Okay, great. Sorry, Husky, you go ahead.
Like, I said, KVD isn't free to play, but that was the first one that jumped in my head. Like, is it? No, but yeah, you're right. It is. Just mostly focusing on group bosses, like we every single boss on there, you know, and it was just kind of feels like against the spirit again, your group Iron Man and probably killing Cerberus, you know.
Yeah, maybe we'll look towards some free to play type things if we decide to hold this type of event in the future, but for now looks like the boss bash is mainly for group bosses, which seem to be members mostly. Will there be a penalty for GIM who join a team just to win the raffle and then leave the team? That was one of the questions that came up. Is that possible to rig it that way or something along those lines? Anyone know?
So from my conversation with ADSE, which is our analytics department. They'll be doing the draw of this. And from, you know, the way we send the data across to them, I believe the winner will be chosen, or sorry, that the group that will win, I suppose, is the group you had at the time of killing the given boss. So if I'm in a group with Husky and Kieran, and we go kill DKs, and my name gets pulled from that DK kill, even if the draw is like a week later, I was still in the group with them at the time, which means that all three of us won, even if I left the group after.
Nice. Sorted. Easy. Okay, so other questions is, what are our plans to stop cheating accounts from winning in the raffle or bots? I know that we do like a sense check on winners generally, like when we're holding a competition, we do that sense check that we do for DMM. So I believe that we'll be doing that in this situation. And I think that's kind of generally how we tend to approach these types of things. But if anybody has anything more to add, let me know.
You covered it. Absolutely. When winners are chosen, the sense checks will be done. And if essentially they've broken the rules, it'll go down to the sort of next pick.
Great. So can the raffle be broken down by team size? For example, a 5-man team might have better odds at winning against a 2- or 3-man team. Is this something we considered?
That's not the plan. It's something I did think about when we were thinking about this sort of design. We thought, rather keep it simple. And now I do realize that means a 5-man team has an advantage over a 2-man. But because it's in this raffle system, and we're not putting it on sort of most tickets wins, or most points wins, it's kind of fair. It's still open to everybody. It's still generally the more you do, the better chance. And it's not going to make a drastic difference at the end of the day. So that was the kind of feeling on it. But it's totally possible we could look at this more in future and we'll see who wins. We'll also be looking at sort of the points distributions and see how many points the group's got. And we can base that stuff on that in future too.
Awesome. Balancing. We can definitely try and do that in terms of future stuff. I do want to get to the tradable untradables question, especially because I know Husky, you have to go a little bit earlier in the stream and I really want to get your take on it. So if we move up to the top, to the general group Ironmen questions, we have a question from a player saying, where is the negative feedback on GIM tradable untradables? Most feedback seems to be in favor of this change. Why wasn't it polled, and would we be open to polling it as most GIM players are in favor of this change? So I'd love to get every single dev's take on this. I'll start with you, Husky, if that's okay. How do you feel about this, and what's your kind of response to this question? Unless you're lagging out, I'm not sure. Husky, are you there?
I'm just going to close abs in case it's something, but can you guys hear me coming through?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Because I heard you lag on my end. Cool. So a lot of people who maybe like within like their circles were like, oh yeah, we really want this, that would be awesome. And I think a lot of group Ironman players generally were for the change, so maybe that's where that perception is. But we put out a lot of different items in that blog. We discussed like, should you be able to trade like things like Barrow's gear and crystal armor, like things that are tradable at a different state, but you just need to do something before you trade it. So it's more like a convenience thing. And stuff was catched with like, should groups only get that feature when that's something that you'd like to be able to do? And realistically, there's no reason why we couldn't just offer that stuff apart from the whole, when you're trading something to somebody, can't currently show the person in the window like what state that's in, like, oh, I'm buying a 2% Torax plate body, so I should be paying less money for like trades. And that generally we would be open offering if we could open it up to everybody else. The other stuff was super controversial though. I mean, I don't know who was it. There was things like, should you be able to trade like golden nuggets to your friend. Like, you did all the mining in Mudlow Mine, you give him the nuggets and he can buy Prospector and stuff, or Graceful, so you can like split up the grinds. And that seems super cool from like a group Iron Man perspective, but that does really open up the ability to get like niche accounts, where, you know, you could suddenly have like an account that's like level 1 agility and has full graceful, right? And then that person de-irons, becomes a main. And that was something there was a lot of backlash on in creating these niche accounts. That was something we specifically didn't want to have available with a group Iron Man game mode, is to have these accounts that like could get into states that the main accounts couldn't. We said that on it. If you were liking the more harmless stuff, potentially we'll relook at it if we get the tech to be able to open that up for everyone else. But as it stands, it just didn't seem fair to offer a benefit to this one group mode over another. And that was the sentiment we seemed to get from the community at the time, right? Because we were kind of on the fence at the time, and that's why we put it in a blog. But, I mean, players might not be remembering all the details now, but that was the conclusion we definitely drew at the time after looking at all that information, right? Again, conversations could open up. If the community suddenly swings the other way, we could change our mind on that and say, sure, groups can do it, but... Yeah, I guess that's what it was. We kind of felt like it was overwhelmingly so mixed that it's not worth pushing. And I guess maybe that does open up the whole, maybe the answer is poll it, but then like, yeah, I don't know. It felt like as well, it was just such a low priority thing for the sake of just like Barrow's armor as well, right? The big part would have been the splitting up grinds, right? Because that changes gameplay drastically for that game mode. You know, set that, you know, trading nuggets, trading all that sort of stuff. So yeah. I don't know. That's just my thoughts and my recollection for when the discussions happened at the time. I'm sorry if you were really looking forward to it, but I guess that's just how things happen sometimes. Some people are really for something and it just doesn't end up determined that it's worth proceeding with on our end, I guess.
Great. Sorry, I think we're like doing some layout stuff because I know Husky needs to dip soon. Thank you, Husky, for that. It definitely seems like the community can swing both ways in this topic, and it definitely doesn't seem like we have an answer yet for them. So maybe it's something that we go away, look at the feedback, and then come back to you on, and maybe not something we can address in this particular blog. I'm really interested to hear, Elena or Kieran, if you have any insight on this particular topic, and if you favor one over the other, like let the chat know what you think.
So, I mean, Husky pretty much covered it all. I think the biggest gripe for me personally is the fact that like players could get into really weird states, and we'd have to like basically make really weird exceptions when a player then decides to de-iron, for example, to try to like put them back into the right state, which can be really tricky, but also it's not really future-proof, if that makes sense. So if we add something else in the future and then we don't consider like the exception upon a player leaving a group and then bringing that onto their now main account, I suppose, that would be very strange.
Cool. It's just me and you, Elena, apparently. Where did Kira go?
I don't know. She disappeared.
Okay. Oh, Kieran's lagging, so it's just two queens on stream today. Sorry, chat. Next question I guess we'll get into is, we've seen a fair amount of feedback about raising GIM group numbers. So this is the player cap, moving groups from like 5 to 6 to even more. Is this something we considered, and is this something we even could do? Is it technically possible, Elena?
With our current engine limitations, it's not really viable because our infrastructure's, when we built a group Iron Man system, it was very much built with the intention of 5 being max. And we can expand it, but it would take a lot of work and a fair bit of engine work as well. So it's not like it's not just changing a variable. It's not trivial to do. That said, theoretically, it is possible to do. It's based on the clan system, and clans can have many, many players. So it's definitely, you know, within the realms of possibility. Oh, Kieran's back.
Hi, Kieran.
Hello.
I missed you.
I switched from my laptop into the streaming room.
You've been running.
We were just talking about raising group Iron Man numbers. Seems like it's possible technically, but it would take a lot of work to do. But we did get a lot of questions on allowing regular Iron Men to join unranked GIM groups. What do you guys think about that? It caused a lot of community discussion online.
So I've been thinking about this a fair bit actually since it came up, and the reason we didn't do this initially on launch was the fact that we didn't have unranked, so everyone was starting fresh on new accounts. And it was that thrill, the excitement of like being, you know, the first one to do X thing, like first one to get a cool drop or first one to max, you know. And we didn't want to take that away from people by letting regular Iron Man convert to GIM. But now that's not really an issue now that we have unranked. So I personally would be open to it. I've seen a fair bit of concern about people bringing in items to the group and that being unfair. But that is going to be a possibility between groups anyway when unranked becomes a thing, because I could be in a group, get a Tebow in that group, and then move over to another group. That is the reason why we had this really strict system in the first place. But a lot of people also found that really inconvenient because they just want to play group Iron Man with the boys or with the gang. And yeah, we found that we'd like to remove the restrictions for the people who just want to play a bit more casually. But then in return, you cannot be on the high scores. Like we want to do that unranked. I've seen a bit of feedback come up as well about wanting to see a difference between these accounts in the game. So if you see someone with the Tebow, like if you see an Iron Man today with a Tebow, you know that that person got it themselves, right? Or, I mean, most of the time. If you see, you know, an Iron group with a Tebow, you assume that some person in that group got it. But with unranked, that's not going to be the case anymore, necessarily. And so we actually have the ability to change that icon if that's something people want. So I could see, you know, there's a world where the unranked group Iron Man icon is green instead of blue, perhaps. I'd be super interested to hear what people think about that. Like, should we make that distinction in game? The reason we didn't offer that initially was because we just didn't want people to feel bad about, like, making that choice, right? You just want to play casually, but people could easily, you know, make fun of you for being a filthy casual or something like that, and we didn't want that to happen. So, but let us know what you think. I'm super interested to hear.
I think the small icon change makes perfect sense, because I think it's about showing off your status. That's the key thing. People can see the level of achievement you've had because of those chat icons. You know, when you see some character and he's studded with a, you know, with the twisted bow, it's important to understand almost like what level of achievement is that? Did they just, you know, buy off the Grand Exchange? Did they just use their mum's credit card and buy bonds and get it from the Grand Exchange that way? Like, or is it an Iron Man who's earned it, or even a group Iron Man, right? I think that's really important. But allowing Iron Man to join unranked, I think that fits perfectly fine. Just about whether we can technically do the work and actually tie that change in. But I always believe it's like it's acceptable as long as a player is moving from a harder game mode to an easier one, essentially. So an Iron Man, you're having to play solo, being able to switch into a game mode while you're playing with, you know, up to four others, that's absolutely fine. Because you're not getting to a position where you can show off achievements that you've kind of circumnavigated.
Great, fantastic answer, and I can see the chat is definitely getting involved with their opinions. That icon change is definitely something we want your feedback on. So if you can leave feedback anywhere on our socials, that would be much appreciated. Following on from this, do we plan to allow GIM to change to regular Iron Man?
No, we will never make that change. It's kind of what Kieran said. We
yeah.
we like going from a harder game mode to an easier one, but we wouldn't want to do it the other way around. If you go from a group, you've had the friend, you've had the help from up to four other friends, and suddenly becoming, you know, competitive with people who've come this far on their own, it's not really fair to those people.
To use an example, you could get a whip from somebody in your group. You could have one Slayer and then become an Iron Man and have a whip, which somebody else has got from 85 Slayer. Like, it just wouldn't, it wouldn't be fair.
Yeah, now that you say it like that, I couldn't see that happening anytime. So some questions about future GIM content came up in the survey. And a lot of players told us they want things like Partner Slayer. Can players expect to see Partner Slayer return in any capacity? What do you guys think?
There's no current plans to, in that specific example. But I do have a huge sort of bee in my bonnet about doing more social content in general, which Partner Slayer obviously does fit. I'd love to understand sort of what people want to see with Partner Slayer. Are they happy for it to just sort of come back almost like it was? And it didn't really have any much incentive other than just, you know, you can have a bit of fun with your friend. It wasn't necessarily efficient to do it unless you were kind of abusing the system. Is that fine? If so, why not? Absolutely, we could bring it back. But generally, I mean, this speaks to something we were talking about yesterday on the Game Jam stream as well. Like, a lot of the content in our game is single player. Right? Old School RuneScape is one of the most single player MMOs, largely, right? You know, apart from some group bossing and some of the more recent stuff we've done, like Guardians of the Rift, you can do it with other people, but you kind of you can form a team and do it. Things like Temporos, where you can do it with other people. But you come back to like mining. If somebody else is in your iron ore spot or your granite mine, you're hopping to find another world. If somebody's chopping your trees, it's a disadvantage to be in the same world. And it's that sort of stuff that I'd love to find a way to make it more social so that you can do it with others. And second to that, I would love to find more spaces for like actual team group content. Rather than just literally you can be around other people, you do it with other people. So sort of like a raid is obviously a team thing. You need a dedicated team to do that. I'd love to have some more of that through sort of like the mid game upwards. Because it really does lack until you get to like end game.
That is an awesome answer. Alina, what do you think? Would you want to see more group content in game?
Oh yeah, definitely. I think group content is really what makes, you know, MMORPGs stand out from regular RPGs. I don't think there's inherently something wrong with allowing solo play in an MMO. I think that's actually really important because if you're like me, you don't always want to spend time with people. I personally like being able to when the time is right, but sometimes I just want to sit back and mine and watch Netflix, you know, or something like along those lines. So yeah, single players.
You don't want to change what old school is at the same time, right?
Yeah, like, exactly.
It's embrace that is part of the game, not diminish it, but just add to it and give you social options. But it is Group Ironman that's really highlighted this to me, certainly. Like, how much fun it is when your group reaches like God Wars and you can team up and do God. Oh my God, it's like you're finally sort of experiencing everything that Group Ironman was sort of designed to be. That it's so much fun getting together with your friends who've worked so hard for maybe months to get together, ready to finally go on that like Bandos trip at God Wars. It is so satisfying. And I really believe like we would love to have more of it. Certainly even earlier than God Wars, because it takes quite a while to even get to God Wars with a reasonable setup, so.
Yeah, I've been saying this before as well, but I'd love to see like more early game, like or early to mid level group bosses. And that's something that came up around the release of Group Ironman, because we're only now, like the majority of people are only now getting to bosses, right? And it's been such a long time since Group Ironman came out. Like, What if we had more to do on the way to this point? That'd be good.
Hell yeah, I hope we do see that, because I'm a very peepo player and I would love more content early game. next question is about GIM displaying prestige status on the high scores. I'm assuming this is something that is an engine issue or engine related thing, but we did see a lot of players ask about it.
Sorry, go on.
No, just really players want an update on when they can display prestige on the high scores.
Yeah, so this is something that we promised in the design, and on the release of Group Iron Man as well, we said that this would be coming, and it is. It has been coded and developed, and it's just awaiting a time to release, really. So it's a matter of weeks at this point.
Yay! Awesome.
Hopefully it comes out with a raffle, but I'm not going to guarantee that.
Hopefully so. We've seen a lot of people say that they want to see it, so that's awesome. Following on from this, it's later down, I think, in the doc, but there was a question as well about displaying Group KC, and we've had a lot of people saying they want to see their boss high scores on the high scores. I know that this is more technically difficult, so if anybody can give an explanation on why this is technically difficult for us to do, that would help. Hopefully you guys know what I'm referring to, right? Boss high scores.
Yeah, the boss high scores. So currently, when you look up like a single player, you can see their boss kills, but you can't see that when you look at a player via the group high scores, and you can't see like the group's combined high scores. It is on their radar for the engine team, but it's just not really... There's been other things that has been higher priority, really. They're having to do a lot of stuff for, you know, leagues and deadman and that sort of thing, but also lots of stuff for raids and just other content that's really been taking up most of the time. But it's still in the backlog of things to do, but we don't have a timeline for when it can get done.
Fair enough. Thank you for explaining, because I remember Ash explaining it on a like in a technical level, and I couldn't catch most of it because it was just way above my head. So hopefully that makes sense to you guys. Next question, are incorrect group sizes going to be fixed on the high scores? I can speak to that one. So we essentially had a tool that would fix all of the incorrect group sizes, which would do it automatically. And we were waiting on that, but unfortunately that tool failed. So we actually need to do all of those manually. So if you can get in touch with me either on Twitter or on socials, oldschoolrs, just send us your group name and size and we'll pass it over and manually fix it. It's not ideal, we know, which is why we're working on that tool, but it hasn't worked so far. So we just need to do it manually. So if you're out there with an incorrect group size, let us know. Okay, for the last like 10 minutes or so, we're just going to fire through some questions about unranked group Ironman. So do unranked group Ironman accounts appear individually on the main high scores?
No, they will appear as if they were a main account.
Fantastic. Would we ever consider allowing them to appear individually on the main high scores?
I mean, it's kind of against the point of it, isn't it? You're unranked. I don't know. I'd be open for feedback on it, but I personally don't think they should be.
Okay. We saw some questions and concerns coming from players, from those who... Oh, actually, we went over this. It's to do with the icons for unranked group Iron Men. So changing the symbol or armor for these new unranked group IMNs was suggested. And we will look at that. We'll look at feedback. So let us know what you think, whether you think unranked mode should have a different symbol, different armor. Leave us your feedback and we will review that. The next question is, what is the main difference
between... Just a note on that, if I can. Sorry. just a quick note on that. We may not be able to do that for launch, but that's definitely something we can just add in later. It has some engine dependency to just like configure the icons properly, so we We can't just do it very fast. It takes a little bit. But we can do it retroactively, so if we do decide to do it and it's not there on launch, it could still be done.
Cool. That sounds good to me. Hopefully you guys caught that. I don't know if I was lagging or what. But yeah, we can retrospectively do that. So no need to panic if it happens and you're unhappy with the current system, we can always change that. What is the main difference between unranked group IMN and main accounts? This was something I saw a lot of players kind of say is, why would you want to be unranked when, you know, main accounts exist? And I was just wondering if you guys have an opinion on what unranked GIM brings to the game versus just playing a main account.
I can see why they'd ask this. I guess the only difference is that the unranked group Iron Man has the ability to be in a group with other players. While as main account cannot. That is really it. There's obviously, you know, the worry about people bringing items across groups and just trading whoever. And yes, that is an issue. That is why we didn't do this initially. But at the same time, I feel like we're kind of moving that moral problem away from like, what's the wording I'm looking for? But we're stopping the game from limiting you, and it's kind of in your hands now to limit how much you want to play into the rules of the game mode, if that makes sense. So yeah, an unranked group Iron Man is just the main. You can group with people if they wish to.
Kieran, did you want to add to that? I could see you kind of...
I just kind of say it as like, well, if you really wanted to become an unranked group Iron Man, to then just spend all the tedious process of grouping up with various different people to get all the items you want, like, you would just probably become a main. This is really for people who still you want to play in the group Iron Man way. You just want to group up with some new people because some members of your group have left. Like, I think it's as simple as that. I think the amount of people who would be sort of abusing this to try and get different items is probably small. This is about allowing people to play group Iron Man because it's fun. People want that social engagement with their friends that they can't currently team up with because our current restrictions stop you from doing that. So I think it's pretty as simple as that. And it's utterly harmless in even if people are going to do that because of the unranked stuff.
That is a fantastic way of looking at it. And I did see a lot of positive feedback for this game mode. A lot of people were saying that it was essentially what they wanted on launch. It's just a casual way of playing. So I'm really happy that those kinds of players are getting essentially what they're looking for. So how do groups deal with items when becoming unranked? Do you still lose all of your tradable items?
No, so you get to keep them.
Awesome, fantastic. Have we considered reworking group storage to protect groups? A player got in touch saying that removing the trade restrictions entirely means potentially people jump into groups, steal all the items from group storage, and run off. What do you think about this?
I think we can easily keep like a... Well, maybe not easily. I don't know. What we can do is add like a time after joining where you can't take anything from the shared storage. Like a... I don't know, like a little like cooldown, I guess, from the time you join. But that should probably come with the toggle as well if we do that, because some groups may actually trust a new member in their group and may just want to let them have whatever. So I could see it going both ways.
And that sounds good. A toggle would definitely be something I would suggest. I don't want to have to sort of nanny the players with stuff like this, because quite reasonably you probably are friends with the person you're inviting to the group and you are saying you trust them. So in theory I think it's fine. And I haven't exactly heard of sort of mass scamming happening with Group Iron Man today. Obviously the restrictions as they stand today don't last that long. So, you know, we could still be seeing that happening, and we're just not.
Okay, so no shady group Iron Men out there. No, we don't accept you. We don't want shady people joining groups. But yeah, it looks like something that we can definitely look into. So that's great. Should we make more solo bosses available to group Irons? So things like Jad, Zora, Inferno, are we going to consider making those available to unranked groups, potentially?
I'm not quite sure what the question is.
As in letting a group
in the survey.
team the fight caves, go and do five man solo or whatever. That's at least
casual,
how I'm interpreting
it.
And I think, sort of for the same reasons we wouldn't allow you to trade fire capes and infernal capes and stuff like that when we were talking about untradeables, like, these pieces of content are still designed to be, you know, solo, and let alone the technical changes that it would take to actually pull it off, it, to me, just undermines the point of the content. And so, I don't think this is a good road to go down. Although five-man Inferno might actually be quite fun. I just don't think it's the right thing to do.
Yeah, I can see the chat is heavily leaning towards no, but it could be just hilarious meme content. I don't know if we can just get a test world and just do it for the memes, but that would be so funny.
Like, we could just put up an experimental server where we just kind of allow some of this stuff. So you can actually do it for the sake of it, for fun, but I don't think it's the right
maybe
thing
a next idea for a league, like, who knows. Will there be restrictions on how often unranked GIMs can join other teams?
So I believe unranked GIM will still have the 1 week like buffer, I suppose, when leaving a group, and this is kind of just a safety measure to make sure that you really want to leave the group and that you're not, you know, you have the time to change your mind. You're not just doing it on the willy-nilly. But also, if your account got hijacked, they can't just leave your group. Obviously, with unranked, you could just be invited back in again, so the consequences aren't that bad. But there is still that, like, 1 week cooldown before you can leave a group. So that's really the only time between swapping groups that we have.
Awesome. Okay, I just want to get into one last question before we end the stream, because it came up a lot in player feedback. So I'm going to hop down to this one. Will we be looking at player-owned housing again? So there was a very frequently asked request for a single player-owned house, or a house which members may access while offline. Just want to address that kind of topic because we saw it come up a lot in feedback, and obviously the devs are here. We did explain at the time that this would be a lot of work when we kind of launch group Iron Man, but any updates on kind of player-owned housing and stuff like that? So yeah, anyone can take this question.
Sure, so when it came up before, with the launch of Group Iron Man, essentially, or just in the months after, we discussed different implementations of this and how it could theoretically be done. One thing that a lot of people wanted was to be able to go to someone's house even though they're offline. Unfortunately, we can't do that due to tech limitations. We can't read a player's variables if they're offline. So you can't, you know, find the right house variables and all that. The other thing we thought about was making something similar to the clan hall. But that was a really, really big project at the time, the clan hall. Or a big part of clans, at least, at the time. And so we didn't feel comfortable spending that amount of time on something that is this niche, you know? And we found that we could instead improve the POH experience for these accounts, which is why you can now like enter your group's house, you can teleport to their house, and that sort of thing.
The teleports have definitely made an improvement. That's certainly made it a lot easier to do this. But yeah, I kind of see it as what people want, right? It's like one member of their group can be the person who trains construction, and then everyone can kind of use that house pretty easily. But yeah, I think unless there's any other sort of obvious easy improvements like the teleporting that we've done, I don't really see a technical way to achieve exactly what people are asking for.
There you have it, guys. We are limited by technology. We really, really, really want to give this to you because we know it comes up so much, but we see it come up so many times, and I just thought it was important for us to address on stream. We hear you, but yeah, we just can't technically see a way to do it at this time. But it's unfortunate, but hopefully the construction grinds go well. We are at time, unfortunately, so we have one last thing to share with you guys before we head out. This is a group Iron Man collage that kindly sent pictures in for. Nothing serious, it wasn't a competition, but here we have some beautiful group Iron Man teams. Oh, look at them. Ignore the ones near the graveyard. Thank you to the team KELA, Just Click, CB, Group Best Friends, Ticking, Max Value, and COT Gang. Wonderful pictures. Keep sending us your screenshots. Maybe we'll do an actual competition. But there you have some teams that are there featured. So thank you so much. We will round off today with some announcements. We'll sign off. So !! Game update, equipment rebalance tier stuff, and Pole 76. Elite clues are in those. Find all of the changes with !! Game update. Next announcement is !! Giants Foundry. The poll for Giants Foundry is now live. Check out version 3 of the blog. It has some super cool changes that we think you will love. !! GIM changes. What we just discussed today, we've got an unranked GIM mode and a raffle going, or it will be going, hopefully. Let us know your feedback. We have a dedicated survey to capture all of that, and tell us what you think. And then lastly, !! TOA rewards. After reviewing your feedback on Tombs of Amaska, we have actually revamped a bunch of rewards. We've seen some really good feedback on it already. If you're a fan of magic, it seems like you're in luck. So !! TOA rewards. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today. Are there any final words, Elena and Kieran? Take it away.
Have a nice weekend.
Absolutely, and, okay. And thanks for tuning in. Thanks so much for all the great feedback on the Tombs of Amaska new reward blog, and all the words on Group Iron Man as well. There's some really good insights there in the feedback, and I'm sure we'll do our best to take it on board.
Hell yes, and thank you so much, Elena and Kieran, for joining us. Thank you so much to Spear for handling all of the live stream stuff. Thank you, chat, for hanging out with us. And thank you for the awesome feedback on the GIM survey. It's been a pleasure reading through all of your questions and feedback and comments. So we will see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.